Is this slide visible? Is it visible to everyone? Is it visible?
Yes, sir. It is visible, sir.
Yes, sir.
So today we are gonna discuss about the assembly language program development tools. Those are used to process any assembly language program instructions, and how they can be used to process any assembly language instruction or mnemonics into a machine code.
Sir, একটু জোরে বলবেন, শুনতে পাচ্ছি
না। এটা শুনতে।
Wait. I just changed my audio device. Need to change it. Okay, wait 1 minute.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, so I will discuss today about the different tools those are used to process any assembly language instructions into the corresponding machine codes or whatever the execution is needs to be take place. So the different tools are used and how they are processed or how what is the function of that tools in assembly language programming development. So I will discuss about that. Okay, so let's start with this slide. So there are several tools available to support the programmer of assembly language for better experience of programming. Okay, and how these tools can be used or what are the different tools those are available for better processing of instructions, assembly language programs, and these are basically editor, assembler, linker, locators, debuggers, and emulators. Okay, so these are the tools by which the programmer can process the assembly language instructions. Okay. So first is the editor tool. Now the basic thing when editor, the function is editor, what is it? This is a program basically which is used to edit which is used to edit or compile or debug a file which contains the assembly language program. Okay, now as the program is typed, the editor stores the ASCII codes for the letters and numbers in successive RAM locations. Like you have keyboard, and which way, which we through which we need to type some letters or some numbers, everything. These will have certain codes. Those are called the ASCII codes, ASCII ASCII codes, and these codes are stored in RAM. Okay, so that when you need to press a button or key, it just transferred the corresponding keys into the corresponding ASCII code, so that your type letter or type any number will be displayed over the screen. Now when the program is typed, suppose it is stored in the memory. Now this file is called the source file. Okay, now the editor edits that source file, which is stored in the memory of a mini computer or microcomputer, whatever. And it basically does these functions like first read the source file or any type of useful information from a reader, means teletype reader, or any from a punch type tape reader, and stores them into the memory. Now then list out a specified part of the entire source file, then delete or insert or replace the specified statements. Okay, after that, it needs to change that specified character string into another one, just conversion. Then search that specified character string, and then it gives the output that source file to any type of terminal. Okay, so basically, now the different examples are here, like PC Write, WordStars. These are the different editors which comes with the assembler. Okay, now that created source file, actually that is to be processed by assembler. Now what is an assembler? Now assembler is a program which is used to translate the assembly language mnemonics for instructions to the corresponding machine codes. Okay, corresponding machine codes. So an assembler basically translates a file of assembly language statements into a file of binary machine instructions as well as binary data. Now the translation process okay, the translation process actually has two major parts. Okay, the first part is to find memory locations with labels. So the relationship between the symbolic name and the addresses is known when the instructions are translated. And the second part is to translate the each assembly statement by combining the numeric equivalent of opcodes. Okay, or it is related to the specified register and labels into a instruction. Now assembler basically produces an output file called an object file, okay, which contains the machine instructions or data or other information. Okay, now an object file typically cannot be executed because it references procedures and data in other files. A label is external, which is also called a global. Last day I have discussed about the global directives. So a label is basically external if the labeled object can be referenced from files other than the one in which it is defined. Okay, a label basically is a label may be a local if the object can be used only within the file in which it is defined. In most assembler, labels are local by default and must be explicitly declared global. We have different subroutines and global variables which requires external labels, since they are referenced from many files in a program. Now local labels hide these names that should not be visible to other modules. Okay, since the assembler processes each file in a program individually and in isolation, it only knows the addresses of local labels. Okay, and assembler basically depends on another tool, that is the linker, which I will discuss next to this slide. Linker to combine a collection of object files and libraries into an executable file by resolving external labels. Okay, the actually now that is the function of an assembler, and also assembler assists the linker by providing lists of label and unresolved references. Okay, so assembler converts basically the assembly language into machine language in two steps, known as assembler pass. Now, in first pass, it determines the displacement of the named data items, the offset of labels, etc., and puts the this information into a symbol table. What is this? Now, actually, it reads each line of an assembly file, and basically it breaks it into its component pieces. Okay. Now, these pieces, which are called lexemes, are individual words or numbers and punctuation characters. If a line begins with a label, the assembler records in its symbol table the name of the label and the address of the memory word that the instruction occupies. Okay. The assembler then calculates how many words of memory the instruction on the current line will occupy, and by keeping track of instruction sizes, the assembler can determine whether or where the next instruction goes. To compute the size of a variable length instruction, an assembler has to examine it in detail. Fixed length instructions, on the other hand, require space, require only a actually it actually performs a calculation to compute the space required for data storage purpose. Okay, now when the assembler reaches the end of the assembly file, the symbol table, which is used to store the records of the data of the location location of each label, then it is used to define it. Okay, the assembler uses this information in the symbol table during a second pass over the file, which actually produces machine code. Okay, now what happened in the second pass? So that is to be that was performed in first pass, and in second pass, what happened? The source program, the assembler produces the binary code for each instruction and inserts the offset. Okay, and that offset can be calculated during the first pass, and the assembler then generates two files. The first one is called the object file with the extension that is .obj, that .obj, and the object file basically, and the second is an assembler list file, which is the .lst. Now .obj object file basically contains the binary codes for the instructions and information about the addresses of the instructions. And second file, which is the .lst, it's a list file. It contains assembly language statements, the binary codes for each instruction, and the offset for each instruction. Now, in what happened in macro assembler, Microsoft macro assembler, the source file name, that is used to assemble the file. You can use any name, MASM, which is called the Microsoft Macro Assembler file name, and then edit source file name, this list file, that is used to view the that list, which is generated when the file is assembled. Okay, so these are the basically functions of assembler, of an assembler. Okay, now it is related to other tools also, like linker. I have told you the linker. So linker basically it's a program which is used to combine numerous object files, several object files into one object file, and convert this object file into an executable file. Okay, into an executable file. Now the linker basically generates a link file which contains the machine codes for all the combined sections of assembly programs. Then it's stored the machine code program anywhere in the memory map, because it doesn't assign absolute addresses to the program. Now due to this the program can be relocated anywhere in the memory to be run. Okay, so in macro assembler, this actually the function of linker is to link the source file, to link the source file. Okay, so that is the function of a linker. And so loader, or somehow it is called the locator, so it's a program. Loader means the locator. It's a program which assigns basically absolute addresses to the program. Now these addresses are generated by adding to all the offsets the address from where the program is loaded into the memory. Okay, so loader basically comes into action when you execute your program. Now this program is brought from memory. So from the secondary memory, the hard disk, the floppy disk, into the main memory at a specific address. Okay, at a specific address. Now assume the program was loaded at addresses at an address 2000. Okay, then this 2000 is added to all the offsets to get the absolute address. Now once the program has been loaded, it is now ready to run. Okay, so actual address means the physical address must be calculated here, but it must be given or assigned. So that is the function of a loader or locator. Okay, then come to the another tool, which is the debugger. Basically debugger is also a program which loads the object code, means the object code means the machine codes program into system memory. Okay, now it also troubleshoots, or it's called the debug, and execute the program. Now during and after executing the program, it monitors the content of registers and memory locations. Now we can change the contents of registers and memory locations after the execution of the program, and then return to the program with the changed values. Okay, we can also put a breakpoint for debugging the program. If a breakpoint is inserted in a program, the debugger will run the program up to the instruction where the breakpoint is set, and stop the execution and display the result up to that point, so that the user can check its program. Okay, so in a Microsoft macro assembler, go file name is issued to debug the file. Okay, debug the file. And also the debugger has different functions. You can write it as, do you have pen and paper with you? If you have, you can write it like the functions of debugger. Basically the first one is the debugger allows looking at the contents of registers and memory locations. Second function is it allows to extend 8-bit register to 16-bit register with the help of extended register option. Okay. Third function is you can write it as debugger allows setting a breakpoint at any point with the program. Okay, at any point with the program. Next function is it will run the program up to the instruction where the breakpoint is set, and then stops execution of the program. At this point, we can examine register contents and memory location content at that point. Okay. Another function, it can view register contents anytime, like I have said earlier, and it can trace the program step by step. Single step execution can be possible, or it can be used to execute the program completely at a time. Okay, so execute the program completely at a time. So these are different functions of a debugger. And next one is the emulators. So emulator is a mixing of hardware and software part, and basically it is used to test and debug the hardware and software both, which is of any external system which is to be connected with the microprocessor based system. Okay, so part of the hardware of an emulator is a multiware cable which connects the connect the host system to the system being developed. So here is a picture of a typical prototype microsystem ES1800 16-bit emulator, which is used to debug or test the both hardware parts and the software parts of an external system. Okay, so that is the emulator. So these are the basically tools, assembly language programming development tools used for processing. And here are the some steps. So how the assembly language program is to be executed. So here is a flowchart. Now you can see that there are steps. These are the steps to develop an assembly language program. First, write down the source code as per the assembly language. They create the object code for the assembly language program, which is basically performed by this assembler, and then link the object code to create an executable file using the linker. Okay, using the linker with the help of list and the libraries. Okay, then it tests and debug the program using debugger, and if there is any error, so it will not be processed. And so if is any error is there, yes, if it has any error, it goes to such level again, it finds the code and process it to the through the assembler to create the object file. Or if is there no error, then it is to be performed well and it is said to be done. Okay, so this is the basically a flowchart, step by step flowchart for assembly language program development. Okay, so these are the basically tools, those are the program components used to write and execute an assembly language program. Okay. So that's all for today. If you have any queries, any doubts, you can ask me.
Sir, debut kare feature stack to abar bolben.
Kon jaga?
Debut kar feature tester abar
functions debugger. allows looking at the contents of the register and memory location. And second function is to extend the 8-bit register to 16-bit register with the help of extended register option. Third function was setting breakpoints at any point within the program. Then if you have set your breakpoint, then debugger will run the program up to the instruction where the breakpoint is set, and then stop the execution of the program. Okay. Now at this point where it is setting the breakpoint, at that position, you can examine the register contents and the memory location contents. Okay. And basically it is used to trace the program step by step operation. And if any error is there, it is basically used to test the programming codes. If there is any error, it can be used to find out that problem. Okay, if there is any error in your source code, and then it executes the program completely at a time. Okay. So these are the different functions performed by the debugger. Okay, so it is a basically debugger is a program which loads the object or machine code program into system memory. Okay, is it okay?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Anyone else?
Sir, last step chart tech to our dekhte chai, sir. Chart
flow chart.
Yes, sir. Flow chart to dekhte chai.
This one. First you need to create, you need to write the sorry
sir BAK ta ki bujhte pachhi na
konda
BAK sir
sir editor side BAK ta bujhte pachhi na
oh eta as for different codes are available. ওকে ওটা ওটা কিছু না ওটা অত বেশি ফলো করার দরকার নেই মেইন থিং হচ্ছে দিস লাইনস okay start then edit using the editor it can be used to create the source code then from source code it goes to object code through this assembler then go to the linker then debugger then take the error and finally it is done okay don't need to give remember these things BAK or LST or LST these are the nominal thing it cannot
my god by what can okay.
বেসিক্যালি এগুলো সেভাবে বোঝার কিছু নেই ইটস আ থিওরিটিক্যাল কনসেপ্ট যখন যেগুলো অ্যাপ্লাই করবে যখন অ্যাপ্লাই করবে তখন আরো ক্লিয়ার হবে বাট অ্যাপ্লিকেশন জায়গাটা খুব কম তোমাদের কাছে
একটা আমার ক্লিয়ার করছি
হ্যাঁ বলো
আগের দিন একটা ক্লিয়ার আমি করতে যাই
হ্যাঁ
স্যার বলছি ইন্টারাপ ভেক্টর টেবিলটা আমি বুঝতে পারছি না 8086
ইন্টারাপ ভেক্টর টেবিল
হ্যাঁ স্যার 8086 ওটা একটু বুঝতে যাই
আচ্ছা ঠিক আছে আর
আগে ওটা একটু দেখতে
এস বিটানু অ্যাসেম্বলার আর লিঙ্কার বুঝতে পারছি না অ্যাসেম্বলার বিটানু অ্যাসেম্বলার বুঝতে পারছো না, অ্যাসেম্বলার ইট ইজ ইউজ টু জাস্ট কনভার্ট দ্য মেশিন মানে বাইনারি কোড, অ্যাসেম্বলি কোড ইনটু আ বাইনারি কোড, লো লেভেল টু হাই লেভেল ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ, মেশিন ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ, নট হাই লেভেল, মেশিন ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ। নরমালি তোমরা সি ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ করেছো, ঠিক আছে, ইটস আ হাই লেভেল ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজ, যেখানে তোমার মেশিন ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজে কনভার্ট করে কে, সেটা হচ্ছে কম্পাইলার। তো অ্যাসেম্বলি ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজের ক্ষেত্রেও এই অ্যাসেম্বলি ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজটাকে মেশিন ল্যাঙ্গুয়েজে কনভার্ট করে হচ্ছে অ্যাসেম্বলার। ওকে, ইজ ইট ক্লিয়ার? লিঙ্কার কি বিতানু, ক্যান ইউ হিয়ার মি? অ্যাকচুয়ালি লিঙ্কার ইটস এ প্রোগ্রাম ইউজ টু কানেক্ট সেভারাল অবজেক্ট ফাইলস ইনটু ওয়ান লার্জ অবজেক্ট ফাইল। ওকে, সো হোয়াইল রাইটিং লার্জ প্রোগ্রাম ইট ইজ বেটার টু ডিভাইড দ্য লার্জ প্রোগ্রাম smaller modules. Okay, now each module can be individually written or tested or debugged. And then all the object modules are linked together to form one functional program, and that is to be performed by a linker. Okay, now these object modules can also be kept in library file and linked into other programs as needed, basically. Okay. আর কোনো কিছু আছে ডাউট? আর কোনো কিছু আছে ডাউট কোনো চ্যাপ্টার?
না স্যার, পড়তে হবে একটু ভালো করে।
স্যার আগে স্যার ইন্টারাপ্ট টেবিলটাই স্যার একটু ডাউট আছে।
ওকে, সো ইন্টারাপ্ট ইয়ে করার জন্য মানে জানার জন্য I need to share my screen, but right now it is not possible to share the screen. So after this meeting you must click on the same link so that come to the next session and we will discuss it. Okay.
Yes, sir.
Or interrupted amar oi slide ta dekhte hobe kothay ache, otherwise ami bollo kichu bujhte parbe na. Acha, tomar kache ki boi ache ei muhurte hater samne? Tale ami bolchi tumi boi ta dekhte paro. হ্যালো
স্যার, আপনার স্যার পিডিএফটাই ফলো করি স্যার।
হ্যাঁ, তাহলে কোন জায়গাটা বলো? কোন জায়গাটা বুঝতে পারছো না সেটা বলো।
হ্যাঁ স্যার ইন্টারাপ্ট টেবিলে স্যার ওই ডায়াগ্রামটাই বুঝতে পারছি না স্যার, মানে কি করে ওগুলোটা হচ্ছে স্যার।
ডায়াগ্রামটা তোমার হচ্ছে মেমোরিতে আছে, ঠিক আছে, মেমোরি 00000 থেকে 003FF অবধি 1 কিলোবাইট অফ মেমোরি লোকেশনস আর রিকোয়ার্ড। এবার ওই জায়গায় আমার তোলা থাকে হচ্ছে যে ইন্টারাপ্ট সাবরুটিনটা আমার এক্সিকিউট করবে, ইন্টারাপ্ট পাওয়ার পরে তো একটা ইন্টারাপ্টের প্রোগ্রাম চলবে, সেই প্রোগ্রামের তো একটা অ্যাড্রেস থাকবে, পার্টিকুলার অ্যাড্রেস। সেই অ্যাড্রেসটা কি করে পাবে, সেগমেন্ট অ্যাড্রেস আর অফসেট অ্যাড্রেস দুটোকে যোগ করলে পাবে। তাহলে সেই পার্টিকুলার সেগমেন্ট অ্যাড্রেস এন্ড অফসেট অ্যাড্রেস এই দুটোকে তুলে রাখার জন্য আমার একটা টেবিল আছে, দ্যাট ইজ কল্ড ইন্টারাপ্ট ভেক্টর টেবিল। আমি যে কোনো ধরনের যদি ইন্টারাপ্ট ইউজ করি, দ্য করেসপন্ডিং আইএসআর এর অ্যাড্রেসটা ওই টেবিলে, যদি আমি ধরো টাইপ জিরো ইউজ করলাম ইন্টারাপ্ট, তাহলে টাইপ জিরো দেখো চারটে মেমোরি লোকেশন দরকার লাগে, দ্যাট ইজ 0000, 0001, 0002 and 0003, ঠিক আছে, একদম লোয়েস্ট নিচের চারটে, দেখো চারটে দেখলে বুঝতে পারবে চারটে মেমোরি লোকেশন স্টোর করে রাখার জন্য দরকার পড়ে। তো এই মেমোরি লোকেশনটাতে কি স্টোর থাকবে, ইন্টারাপ্ট সার্ভিস রুটিনের অ্যাড্রেস। নাও ইন্টারাপ্ট সার্ভিস রুটিনের দুটো অ্যাড্রেসকে কম্বাইন করলে আমি একটা ফিজিক্যাল অ্যাড্রেস পাবো, 20 বিট ফিজিক্যাল অ্যাড্রেস। এবার দুটো অ্যাড্রেস মানে সেগমেন্ট অ্যাড্রেসও আমার 16 বিট আর অফসেট অ্যাড্রেসও হচ্ছে 16 বিট, কিন্তু এক একটা মেমোরি লোকেশন আমার কত বিট স্টোর করতে পারে, 8 বিট স্টোর করতে পারে। তাহলে সেগমেন্ট অ্যাড্রেস 16 বিট, অফসেট অ্যাড্রেস 16 বিট, তাহলে টোটাল কত হচ্ছে 32 বিট। তাহলে 32 বিট কোনো কিছু স্টোর করতে গেলে আমার কটা কনসিকিউটিভ মেমোরি লোকেশন লাগবে, চারটে, বিকজ এক একটা মেমোরি লোকেশন 8 বিট স্টোর করতে পারবে। তাহলে লোয়ার 8 বিটে আমার স্টোর হবে হচ্ছে, দেখো একটা অ্যাড্রেস, দ্যাট ইজ দ্য আইপি, আর তার উপরে দুটো কনসিকিউটিভ মেমোরি লোকেশনে স্টোর হবে হচ্ছে আমার সিএস সেগমেন্ট অ্যাড্রেস, ঠিক আছে। সো প্রত্যেকটা ইন্টারাপ্টের জন্য যেই ইন্টারাপ্টটা আমি ইউজ করব তার করেসপন্ডিং আইএসআর এর অ্যাড্রেসটা ওই ইন্টারাপ্ট ভেক্টর টেবিলের পার্টিকুলার ইন্টারাপ্টের চারটি মেমোরি লোকেশনে স্টোর থাকবে, দ্যাট ইজ কলড দ্য ইন্টারাপ্ট ভেক্টর টেবিল।
আচ্ছা স্যার,
শুধু আমার পিপিটি পড়লে হবে না, প্রেজেন্টেশনের স্লাইড গুলো পড়লে হবে না, ইউ মাস্ট ফলো দ্য টেক্সটবুক অলসো।
আপনি স্যার একই স্যার বলতে গেলে, মানে একই স্যার আপনি করাচ্ছেন, এই জন্য স্যার আপনার